wanted to show you the Aurora tonight. Here it is in all its splendor. You can see the greens dancing around. This is one of the reasons why I love this camera. This is the Sony A7S. It is absolutely a monster when it comes to low light. This is basically an eighth of a second at ISO 256,000, which is insane. But you can see how big it is. There's these are the Pleiades, Hades, Taurus, Jupiter. And you can see how big the Aurora actually is. There she is. Wow. Holy moly. I'm just standing on my deck here. Let me just move around a little bit and see where else I can see it. But there she is. And this is, by the way, handheld. This Sony A7S is just absolutely amazing. This is one of the reasons why I bought it, for looking at satellites and meteors. But also the Aurora. This is totally unmodified stock camera. It's just wild. I'm going to raise the ISO a little bit. This is ISO 320,000. It's absolutely unbelievable. The lens that I'm using today is actually a vintage 1970s lens. It's a 50 millimeter f1.4. Holy cow. That is just amazing. Live shot, handheld. I dare you to beat this with any other camera. The whole sky is on fire. This is so worthwhile. I'm freezing my butt off. It's about 43 degrees. But spectacular. is amazing too. Typically we just see the green, but it is so intense that we can see the reds as well. This is real time. This is how it appears in the sky. Granted, with my own eyes, I can see it, but you know, it's not as defined as what this camera shows me. This camera clearly is hugely much more sensitive to light. I mean, if I look to the north now, which is where I'm pointing, I can barely see it. I mean, I can see the glow and I can see the pillar of light, the red light, with my unaided eye, but it's kind of faint. And I can use my averted vision, I'm looking off to the side a little bit, and I can see it better. But as you can see, it comes in so vividly in the camera view. In fact, another interesting thing about this camera is, and I kid you not about this, I can take handheld images of the Milky Way, the meteors, the aurora, just like I'm doing now. This is a movie that I'm taking with just holding it in my hands, standing on my deck. And if I wanted to, I could put it into photo view. And take a few photographs. It was interesting. This is in a direction of northeast. And initially, I was seeing it more or less here, which is northeast, as you can see. This is the Little Dipper, as you can see right there. This is, in the center, is Polaris. Little Dipper is right there. And you can see those pillars in that general direction as well. But wow. This was so worth it. Thinking about putting the camera on the tripod and just letting it run. In fact, I almost panicked. I went downstairs and the batteries were not charged. So I quickly charged them up and we're off and running. Okay, so I'm gonna end this video, and if it picks up again, I might do another. Oh, look at that pillar. Wow. That's amazing. That is so cool. It looks like, green is back. Red's kind of fainted a little bit, but they'll come back. And like I said, there's one giant pillar right there. Not too far from Jupiter. Jupiter is the bright one to the right. And the pillar runs through the constellation of Auriga. wicked cool. Okay, I'm gonna turn it off and come back.